गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर गोरांग रीडर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ओरल एंड मैक्सिलो फेशियल सर्जरी, महात्मा गांधी मेडिकल यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग ए टॉपिक, एनाटॉमी ऑफ ऑर्बिट एंड इट्स अप्लाइड। इंट्रोडक्शन। ह्यूमन ऑर्बिट इज ए स्मॉल बोनी कोन फिल्ड विद ए न्यूमरस वाइटल एंड डेलिकेट स्ट्रक्चर। इट इज एन एवरेज हाइट ऑफ 35 mm and mediolaterally width 40 mm. In orbit, an intraorbital volume of an adult is 30 to 35 cubic centimeter, while the volume of globe is 7 cubic centimeter. Medial wall are parallel to each other and are around 40 to 55 in length, while lateral wall are 90 degree to each other and are 40 to 45 mm long. The major structure that occupy the orbit are the globe, orbital flare, fat, extraocular muscle, ciliary ganglion, nasolacrimal apparatus, optic nerve, oculomotor nerve, trochlear, abducens, V1, V2, trigeminal nerves, and ophthalmic vessels. Bone forming the orbit. Each orbit is made up of 7 bones. First is the maxilla, second is the frontal, zygomatic, sphenoid, ethmoidal, lacrimal, and the palatine bone. These are the structure. Roof of the orbit, orbital plate of the frontal bone, lesser wing of the sphenoid, medial wall, orbital plate of the ethmoid, lacrimal bone, frontal process, floor, orbital process of palatine bone and orbital surface of the maxilla, supraorbital foramen, optic foramen, superior orbital fissure, lateral wall of orbit, inferior orbital fissure, infraorbital foramen. Lateral wall is comprises of zygomatic process of the frontal bone, greater wing of sphenoid bone and orbital surface of the zygomatic bone. Orbital wall. In older patient, there may be spots of resorption in the orbital floor, which may cause the dura to adhere to the periorbit of the roof. The junction of the medial wall of the roof has a suture line which lie in a close proximity to the cribriform of the ethmoid and is bound off for fragments. This may be a major concern of CSF leak in orbit and ANOVA fracture. Thickest wall and thinnest wall, primarily by the orbital surface of the zygomatic bone and the greater wing of sphenoid are the thickest, and a small bony projection seen on the lateral wall is the vitreous tubercle, which is 11 mm below the frontozygomatic suture and 4 mm behind the rim. These tubercles form the attachment of the 4L, that is a suspensory ligaments and suspensory ligaments of Lockwood, lateral horn of a levator epinosis, ligaments of the lateral rectus muscle, lateral palpable ligament. Orbital wall. The orbital foramen is in continuation of a medial wall and is approximately placed 40 to 50 mm behind the medial wall. The safe distance the surgeon need to remember are 24 mm of anterior ethmoidal artery with an additional 12 mm for the posterior ethmoidal vessel and a further 6 mm as a limit to stay away from the optic foramen, making it 24-12-6 as a easy formula to remember. One most important structure which may be involved in a medial wall trauma is a medial rectus muscle, which can get entrapped, causing ocular motility disturbances. Follow a gentle slope from its medial to lateral side. The highest point lies in the post-medial aspect of the floor, form a bulging called Hammons key area. Sagittal view of the floor form a lazy S form. Classification. Monsoon and colleague classify the fracture based on the energy of impact and degree of and extent of the communicated displacement observed on CT. Trapdoor fracture, middle blowout fracture, lateral blowout fracture. Low velocity fracture are trapdoor fracture, immediate velocity injury, medial blow, and lateral high velocity. Converse and Smith termed as a pure and impure based on the involvement of the orbital rim. Pure blow-in, blow-out fracture. Fracture of the internal wall with intact rim. Impure, complex with involvement of one or more rim associated with rims. Fracture of the rims. Hammer described four classes of orbital fractures based on their occurrence with their other fractures like type 1 orbitogigometric fracture. These involve the fracture of the wall of the orbit along with gigometric complex. Type 2 internal orbital fracture. These involve associated fracture of any of the wall, roof and floor. Type 3 ANOVA fracture, naso orbito ethmoidal type fracture. These involve fracture of the naso orbito ethmoidal complex, which involves the orbit. And type 4 complex with of a face. This type involves fracture of the orbit with contaminated fracture of the face other than the mentioned above. Structure passing to the superior and inferior orbital fissures, lacrimal nerve, frontal nerve, trochlear nerve, superior nerve, supraorbital fissure, inferior orbital fissure, and optic nerve, ophthalmic artery, and rest on mark diagram. Muscles, intraocular muscles, orbital muscles are divided into intraocular and extraocular. Intraocular ciliary and extraocular are involuntary and voluntary. Involuntary are superior tarsal muscle and inferior tarsal muscle. Voluntary are levator papyrus superiorsis, superior rectus, inferior rectus, medial rectus, lateral rectus, superior oblique and inferior oblique. Muscles of orbit as shown in figure. Common tendon rings, inferior rectus muscle helps in the movement of the eyeball, superior rectus muscle, lateral rectus muscle. Intrinsic muscle of the eye, muscle ciliary, location muscles, fibers in a ciliary body, innervation parasympathetic from the oculomotor, constrict ciliary body, relax tension on the lens and lens become more round. Sphincter papillary, circularly arranged fiber in the iris, parasympathetic from oculomotor, constrict pupil, dilate pupil, muscle name dilate pupillary, radially arranged fiber in the iris, dilate pupil. These are the movements which eyeball do: elevation, depression, abduction, adduction, intrusion, extrusion. Lacrimal gland is also there. Connective tissues, orbital septa, tarsal plates are there, conjunctiva, transparent mucosa membrane that cover the frontal surface of the globe and the inner surface of the eyelid. Two segments, the bulbar conjunctiva cover the anterior part of the sclera, the white part of the eye. The palpebral conjunctiva known as transverse conjunctiva, which covers the inner surface of the eyelid. Facial sheets of eyeball. The facial sheets of eyeball is called tenon capsule. It extends from the optical foramen to the scleral junction involving the eyeball of the inferior aspect. It attaches to the sclera on the anterior and the posterior surface of the eyeball and become continuous with the fascia of the muscles posteriorly and around the inferior oblique muscle. The fascia sheet of all muscle glands together and form a continuous facial bands called superior suspensory ligaments of the eye that provide support to the eyeball. Orbital fat is present both intra and extra coronally. They cushion the globe and muscles of orbit. The extra coronal fat determines and influences the position of the globe, and this may be altered either due to the herniation and atrophy secondary to fracture of the orbital result in anophthalmos. Blood supply. Ophthalmic artery is a branch of the internal carotid artery. The central artery of the retina. Branches of this ophthalmic artery are the central artery of the retina, muscular branches, ciliary arteries, lacrimal arteries, supratrochlear and supraorbital arteries. Nerves of the orbit are the oculomotor nerve, nasociliary nerve and abducens nerve. Ciliary ganglion has also passed from this internal carotid plexus into the orbit and runs through the ganglion without interruption. Classification. These we discuss already that Monsoon and Khalid classify the fracture based on the type of the bone, velocity and involvement of the rim and non-involvement of the rim, pure and impure. Now, clinical feature of the orbital floor fracture. Periorbital edema, periorbital ecchymosis, subconjunctival hemorrhage, contusion hematoma, subcutaneous emphysema with cryptus, laceration involving the eyelid, injuries to the canthal apparatus, and neurological deficiency of the infraorbital and facial nerves. You can appreciate in the figure. Doll's eye sign, the oculocephalic reflex, Doll's eye reflex, an application of a vestibulo-ocular reflex, VOR, used in neurological examination from cranial nerve of 3rd, 6th and 8th. The reflex are include brain stem nuclei and overall gross brain stem function, often used to examine patient in neurological critical care setting, may have utility to assess neonates, anesthetized patient and dizzy patient. The reflex derived is the name of a characteristic Doll's eye appearance the patient has his reflex is possessed. Retrobulbar hemorrhage, vision threatening emergency which occurred due to accumulation of the blood in a retrobulbar space. This cause increased intraorbital pressure resulting in compression or stretching of the optic nerve and reduced perfusion to the eye. Orbital trauma, especially blunt injury, and may be associated with retrobulbar hemorrhage which warrant immediate attention. In unconscious patient, a pupillary assessment, increased pressure and presence of a relative different pupillary defect or diagnostic tool. It is present as a reduced ocular motility, elevate intraocular pressure, ptosis, and the diminishing vision. Diplopia, double vision. Lacrimal system injuries. You can appreciate in this diagram that block NDL with a no drain of the eye. So for this we will do the dice cystogram to evaluate the bone and then followed by DRC. Anophthalmos or hypothalmos. Clinically, anophthalmos can be detected by aggressive suprapalpable fold, reduced projection of the viewing from the frontal view.